Hey folks, AJ the CEO here, and one of the best ways to share your message with more people is to add subtitles. Now, with AI and not even just AI, just tools in general, this is something very simple that doesn't cost anything except for a little bit of your time. And I want to walk you through how to do that just to add your content and make it available to other people that don't naturally speak your language that you're going to be using in. So obviously, I speak English. I know enough French to be dangerous as well as Spanish, but not enough to be fluent. But say you want to have those demographics and you want to offer those things to that wider community. Let me walk you through how simple that is to actually do. All right, so I'm going back here behind a sermon that I edited for Antioch a while ago. And thankfully, a bunch of new tools have been available in YouTube that you can pull the transcripts, because AI is actually running in the background of all your videos and it's actually transcribing it. So that's what I'm going to leverage right now. So if we come into any video that you choose, you obviously got to give it some time. So you can't just finish live streaming and expecting it to happen like that. But if we come over here to subtitles, and this one right here is the one that's normally made transcribed live. So if this is done, you can come over here and click download. I'm going to select SRT because that's actually the format that gives timestamps and everything, so it knows where to display the text at the same time. So we're going to go ahead and download that. Now, one thing you will want to do if you don't have it, you want to open this up, and it opens in Notepad. So what I need to do is we need to put this in a document format. So you can, if you have Word, you can just copy that and paste it in there. If you don't, you can open up Google Drive and then just make a new document here. Let's make a new Google Doc. And let's go ahead and copy everything that's in this file. We're going to paste it. All right. As you can see, it has a timestamp. It has the words. You might want to go in here and just make sure that everything is accurate. From a text standpoint, it all depends on how long the sermon is. Now, this video that I'm using is the sermon only. Realize if you live stream the entire service, this is going to be take a little bit longer. So I'm only doing a sermon here. So now that we got this done, let's call it whatever. I'll say it's ABC English. All right. So we're going to save that, and we want to download it as a Word document. So that's if you don't have Word. If you have Word, just do it in that way. Now let's go over to translate.google.com. And we're going to translate this as a document. We're going to translate a document that's in English, and then you can pick whatever language. I'll pick Spanish. So I'm going to pull that same file I just did here. We just hit translate, download the translation, and there we go. So if we open this up, and it opened in Word. I could have opened it back up in Drive. But there you go. It has translated this into Spanish. All right. So now that we've got this all done, let's go ahead and select it all. And we're going to go back to Notepad because we need to put it back in an SRT format. So let's just make a new file. I'm just going to paste it in there. Now, we need to eyeball this just to make sure that there are no issues in it, but we'll show you if you have an issue how to fix this as well. So now let's save this. I'm going to name it to my desktop and just call it ABC Spanish. And I want to make it a .srt file. Change the text documents to *.*, so that way it won't put a text TXT at the end of the file. All right, we got it saved. So now let's go back to our video. We're going to add a new language. Pick the language, which is going to be Spanish because that's what we used. All right, and we're going to hit the pencil. And we're going to upload our file. And it is with timings. That's what that time is in the file that we used. So let's go to continue, select our file. I had it on the desktop. That's the ABC Spanish, open, and boom, there it is. Now, if there was an error, it would normally tell you, oh, the error is on this line. So if you have Notepad here, the line is down here. So you would just go to the line where it is and fix whatever it is. Most of the time, it's something like this, where there's an extra space or something inside the time and it can't read it. That's pretty much it. So now that we got this done, we're just going to publish this. And now we have that language. So if we come back here to the video now, and we go here to the sermon, so you see, naturally, because of the default language that I have, English is showing up. But if we come over here to the gear and we change our subtitles, we can select our language. So now it is Spanish. And there we go. So now that is what's translated. So when somebody is watching whatever videos, you would have that other language. Now, there are other tools that I would recommend if you wanted to actually know. I mean, it's out of habit. You could just be, okay, let's just put these languages and do it in all the languages that you want. But you might not want to do that. So there's a tool that I use. I have a link down below, an affiliate link if you would like to get it, is TubeBuddy. I've been using this for years. Now, when I go into TubeBuddy, it will actually give me some analytics on what are the languages that most people are watching my videos. So if I go over here to my latest install video and I come back down here to subtitles, it's going to add a bar here and it's going to tell me in a graph what percentage of people are actually watching in other languages. So now I could focus this on any other language that I want. So like Hindi, Filipino, German, Indonesian, Spanish, Portuguese. If I really wanted to be, you know, fancy, you could just translate everything into the most common languages and you just make them readily available. But that's pretty much it. Let's go back through it again. We would just go into our subtitles, the one that's automated, automatic captions. We come down here, download that file, save it as a Word document, go to Google Translate, change it to documents, upload that document, pick the language that you want it to be translated into, download that file, copy it, save it as a SRT file, then go back into Google, add that new language. As you see, I added Filipino and Hindi for this video because that's where the most in there. Upload that, and now you have your content available in another language that you did not have to speak, and you use the tools that are available to allow that to be in any other language. So I hope that helps you out. That's one short little thing that took maybe like 3 minutes, if not less, to do. And now you've broadened the content to being able to reach more people throughout the entire world. So even if you were a little church out there in Bug Tussle somewhere, but now your content is now available to people that speak other languages. So I hope that helps. If you like this type of content, appreciate a like, consider subscribing, hit that bell, that way you get notified when we come up with other videos to help modernize your media ministry. Thanks for watching, folks. This is AJ. Catch you on the next video. Later.